Get ready to match the stars. Richard Deacon. Fannie Flagg. Charles Nelson Reilly. Mary Wickes. Richard Dawson. And Joyce Bulifant. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn.
Don, how are you? Okay. I thank you for showing up here today, and you too indeed. Listen, we're sorry to announce that we had to give What's-Her-Name a day off. But we're very pleased to announce we got Fanny in place of What's-Her-Name.
Thank you. You know what, Fanny? Thank you.
What?
Brett left me the Encino Motel key.
Okay, honey.
Swallow it.
Swallow it? No.
No, he has a bad cold. Swallow the cake. Oh, okay.
Kiss me, Richard.
No.
Nice to have you back, Richard.
Thank you very much.
Yes. How's it going to be without Brett?
Without who? Well, I've completely forgotten already. That's how I am.
Richard?
Yes.
You dropped something.
Have a screw loose, obviously.
Yeah, obviously.
Check that out.
All right, here we go. What do you say we greet our two players, Bonnie Middlebrooks and Pamela Cusiora? Bonnie's the current champ. She's won $1,200.
Yeah.
And she's happy about that. Now, Pam, how you doing?
I have four.
You got four? Say, that's good. That's, you don't think I'd say anything to that, do you know? Well, Pam, that means Bonnie's got to get four to catch up with you. But if she matches five, well, then she'll beat you. See, that's the way it goes there. So the score is 4-0. We're in the middle of round two. This is the final round. We'll see how this game ends right after we see about this. All right, here we go. Now, this is the final question in this game, Bonnie. Four to tie and five to win. Oh. Everyone will play.
Why not?
Mr. Dumb Donald, the hairdresser, is really dumb. You are very alert.
Oh, sorry, your feet were right
too
there.
Noisy for you?
Well, too noisy, I can't stand it.
No, that was very good, isn't it?
Okay.
Anyway, he's really dumb, this Dumb Donald, the hairdresser. When the customer asked him for bangs, Mr. Donald put a blank in her ear. Mr. Dumb Donald, the hairdresser, is really dumb. When the customer asked him for bangs, Mr. Donald put a blank in her ear. Okay?
Put a blank in her ear.
Put a blank in her ear.
That's very funny.
Blank in my ear.
Yes.
You answered it yourself. Put a blank in her ear.
Mr. Dumb Donald, the hairdresser, is really dumb. Mm. When the customer asked him for bangs, Mr. Donald put a blank in her ear. Don't say it yet,
ear
Bonnie.
Ear or hair?
Ear.
Ear. Oh,
ear.
Thank you.
Is don't I enunciate I clearly enough? I have spent my entire life in the field of communications.
Really?
What are you doing, Richard? We're stalling, waiting for
I'm
you.
Sorry.
All right, Richard. Just for that, we're cutting your salary in half.
Then I'll go home.
Dumb Donald the hairdresser is really dumb. When the customer asked him for bangs, Mr. Donald put a blank in her ear.
Gun.
A gun. All right. Guess one could associate a gun with a bang, right?
One could.
Mm-hmm.
One did.
Oh, one did. Yeah. All right. Score is now 4-1. What did you say, Fanny?
Well, before I answered, I wanted to say to Brett, I spoke to your lawyer. The parole looks good, sweetheart. Choo-choo your cellmate. Unfortunately, I said firecracker.
Firecracker?
Yeah, sorry.
Well, no, that they go bang on the 4th of July. Now, that's not a bad answer at all. It's a very good one, Chuck.
It's Brett, the woman with glasses.
She's the one with, yeah, right, right.
I hope it's a match bullet.
A bullet. No. Now, Bonnie, you must match the three remaining ones on the bottom to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Mary, we are up to you.
Well, I want to take up a collection for Brett, because we're all going to send her some files and things, you know.
To get her out.
Little things in the cell that would be comfy.
Yes.
All right. Now then...
Looking for a gun.
Oh, you got it.
One gun. 4-2 the score. You offer her a gun or a bang?
Firework.
A firework. So that means Pamela wins the game. What'd you have, Joyce? Cap gun. Congratulations. Hang around right here and wait for me. I'll get to you in a moment or so. We're going to say goodbye to Bonnie Middlebrooks.
Thank you.
Who's going to leave here with $1,200.
Thank you.
A pleasure to meet you, Bonnie. Goodbye. What?
I didn't know I had won.
You didn't know you had won until you heard the thing going ding, 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 ding? Well, you did it. Now you've got it. Only, you've only got $100. That isn't bad, but you could win over $5,000 here. Now, Pam, with this big audience match, not too long ago, we polled a group of people in this very building. We said, you write down your best answer to this, getting blank. Now, the answer they... Stop that, John. Getting blank. Now, the answer they gave us most frequently, if it's matched by you, we'll get you $500. If you match your second most popular answer, you get $250. And then for matching the third, you get $100. And three of our six are permitted to assist with verbal responses.
Good. I couldn't think of anything. Fanny.
I will reply in a musical number, getting to know you, getting to know all about you.
Okay, thank you.
I'm in charge, Richard.
Richard,
please, yes.
Getting it on.
Getting it on?
Is that what they were calling it?
You are a Randy Bunch.
Is that what they were hollering about? Okay. I want to try Charles, please.
You want to try Charles?
Everyone has.
How about getting hot?
Getting hot?
Thank you so much.
You got us.
Or getting Gertie's garter, but that's...
No.
That's 50 years ago.
Yes.
Well,
no, getting hot is his answer. Getting to know you was Fanny's, and getting it on was Richard's, and you may choose one of those three.
I like the crowds and Richard getting it on.
You mean the crowd and Richard all the... Oh, really? Okay. I want to see that now. Let's begin at the bottom, and we will reveal the $100 response. Getting better. It's a nice, simple, straightforward, direct statement, isn't it?
I guess, yeah.
Yeah. We're looking for getting it on. May we see the next one, getting together. Well, so far, they didn't give you nothing over there. But we'll all keep our fingers crossed for you right now, Pamela, because this is the big one. Go! Fanny's answer.
You
misled her, you see. Did you really think it was going to be getting it on up there? Well, you were wrong. Now, Pamela, you're going to meet another player a little bit later. Right now, we've got to do a little business with America. Come back and see who our new competitor is. Here we go. Well, hello. There's Joe Bujanovic. Hey. Dobro. You don't meet too many Bujanovic's in this world. It's a real Serbian name, right?
Serbo-Croatian,
yeah. Where were your parents born?
They were born in a little town across the Danube from Belgrade called Pančevo.
And where were you born?
I was born in Cairo, Michigan.
Cairo, Michigan. What do you do, Joe?
I retired about 6 months ago as a bartender from the Greater Los Angeles Press Club.
Uh-huh.
And the reason I retired at 62 was about 2.5 years ago. I play the horses, and I happened to win a handicapping contest, $50,000.
$50,000.
And the way that I got to California in 1958,
yeah?
I had a horse drawn in Irish sweepstakes, and I bought a one-way ticket out here.
And what did that get you?
About $1,600.
$1,600. Yeah. What the hell are you doing here, Joe? You don't need the money.
I just came here to say hello to you and serve a crow.
Do you speak that language?
I speak it because half of my two sisters and older brother were born in Yugoslavia, what is now Yugoslavia.
So you spoke that a lot around the house.
Around the house.
When he came on the program there, you may not have heard him. You were still applauding. He said, "Kako ste vi," which means, "How are you?" And I said, "Dobro, hvala lijepa," fine, thank you. And now that we've gotten that out of the way, Joe, you may have A or B.
I have a rare blood type called AB, so I'll start with A.
A. There isn't anything we don't know about you, Joe. I mean, there isn't anything we don't know about Joe.
AD?
AB.
AB.
Ugly Edna's parents said, "We knew our baby would be ugly from the very beginning. Our first hint was when the stork who delivered her was blank." That's how we knew the baby would be ugly from the very beginning, when the stork who delivered her was blank.
What is it, 12 inches already?
Turbo Croatian.
Now let's see. Ja imam jedan... Kako se reče horse? Coin. Ja imam jedan coin za tebe.
Have I got a horse for you?
Okay. All right, you ready, Joe? Here we go. Ugly Edna's parents said, "We knew our baby would be ugly from the very beginning. Our first hint was when the stork who delivered her was blank."
Drunk.
Drunk. That's a reasonable response from a former bartender.
I thought he didn't want to look.
Blindfolded. He didn't want to look, yes. Okay, Richard. Fanny, what do you say?
Joe, crocus begonia.
Crocus begonia? That's nothing.
Sounds good. I said the stork was laughing.
The stork was laughing.
That's funny.
All right.
I said the same as my neighbor from up Coldwater Canyon, blindfolded.
Blindfolded. All right. Now, Mary, we knew the baby would be ugly from the very beginning when the stork who delivered her was...
You know, you have to have an awful big house if you're a coin collector in Serbo, Croatia, don't you?
Why?
Because a coin is a horse. Yeah! Blindfolded. I tried.
And you missed. But I thank you for trying.
That's all right.
Just missed.
I'm here
by
to help.
What is it?
The flip of a horse.
Blindfolded.
Blindfolded seems to be the answer, yeah. Joe. What do you say, Joyce? Oh, yes,
oh, it's
darling.
It's going to be a good one.
Oh, it's going to be a good one.
She's are you going to believe this?
What?
I speak Yugoslavian too. Is that the language?
Serbo-Croatian is the official name.
Yes. Only this way, mentally.
Yes.
Not mouthily.
Not mouthily.
Drunk.
Drunk. Okay. One for Joe Bujanovic. All right, Pam, you know what to do. Norm said you can tell Ramar the hunter has been hunting in Central Park. He came home with a blank strapped to his fender. All right. All right. Everybody ready, Pam? Norm said you can tell Ramar the hunter has been hunting in Central Park. He came home with a blank strapped to his fender.
A bra?
A what? A bra, did you say? Ramar the hunter.
And he was hunting in Central Park?
In Central Park.
And this girl's things? No?
Oh. Oh, you mean he molested a girl and ended up with a bra?
No, not that bad.
No? Oh, I see. Okay, what did you say, Richard?
I said the obvious, mugger.
A mugger, yeah. See, the common belief is that there are muggers in Central Park. Of course, there aren't any.
She's never been there.
Yes.
Mugger.
Mugger. That seems to be the answer there, Pam.
Whether he had a bra on or not, we don't know.
No, we'll never know. Some of them do. Now, Pamela, we come to Mary Wicks.
Yeah.
She's looking for a bra.
A bra?
Yeah.
She ain't gonna get it. Mugger.
A mugger. All right. What do you say, Richard?
I'd say Erin go bra.
Erin go bra. And now, are you going to do the hat trick
here
again,
we go.
Joyce?
No, I wish I did come up with a bra. But, we all look for different things in Central Park.
Of course we do.
I looked for, and I always find, and I thought he came up with a popcorn vendor.
Popcorn vendor. Strapped to the fender, huh?
This girl is not well.
Yeah. As a matter of fact, you. Joyce, if you did have a bra, you would come up. Yeah. So. One to nothing is score at the end of round one. Round two coming up after this.
You got a point.
1 point. There we go. Thank you, John. Now we go to round two. This is the final round, Joe. You may have A or B.
B.
B it is. One person does not play, and that's Miss Smart down there. After Carl the cannibal ate the cowboy, he said, "One thing about that cowboy, he sure had blank feet." After Carl the cannibal ate the cowboy, he said, "One thing about that cowboy, he sure had blank feet." Cowboy, cannibal.
Got it.
All right.
Mm-hmm. Hi, Richard.
Mm-hmm. Hi, baby.
I miss you.
Here we go, Joe. After Carl the cannibal ate the cowboy, he said, "One thing about that cowboy, he sure had blank feet."
Smelly feet.
I think we're going to have to deport you back to Yugoslavia, Joe.
Or Cairo.
Or Cairo, Michigan. What do you say?
I thought of that, but it disturbed me so much that I said tough.
Tough, yeah. Toof, right. Toof, what?
He wouldn't have been a tenderfoot. He was a cowboy. He would have been a tough foot. Yes?
Tough foot. Tenderfoot would have been an interesting response, though, Charles.
I chose tenderfoot.
Tenderfoot is interesting. Tenderfoot. Have you ever heard of a tenderfoot cowboy there?
A cowboy wouldn't be a tenderfoot.
No?
That's them people from the city.
Oh, I see.
I said he had tough feet.
Tough feet.
Could hardly get him down.
And Richard.
Well, I said tenderfoot.
That's
tenderfoot
not a
is
cowboy.
A good answer.
I
yeah,
said smelly.
Wasn't there a cowboy named Tenderfoot?
Nobody cares. I said smelly.
Get out of here. Now, this puts Pamela in the catbird seat, Joe, because all she has to do is match one to tie and two to win.
Mercy.
Everyone plays. Little Rodney Rotten is really rotten.
I'll tell you.
Yeah, he wants to be a carpenter when he grows up, and to practice, he nailed his blank to the wall. That's how rotten Rodney Rotten is. He wants to be a carpenter when he grows up, so to practice, he nailed his blank to the wall.
Boy, that kid is rotten.
He's a rotten kid.
Oh, boy, is he rotten.
A rotten kid. Good. Got some. All right.
He nailed his.
He nailed his blank to the wall. All right, Pam. Little Rodney Rotten is really rotten. He wants to be a carpenter when he grows up. To practice, he nailed his blank to the wall.
Okay. Would you tell him don't boo me?
No booing.
His mother?
His mother. Two mothers booed, the teenagers applauded. Richard?
When I have a problem at home, I call a plumber to screw in a light bulb.
Yes.
So I know about this guy. So I said thumb.
Nailed his thumb to the wall.
Sorry!
He nailed his thumb to the wall.
Do not turn into a mob!
Yes?
Yes, I'm getting fallout from a contact boo. I agree with you, my dear. Mother.
Mother. One more mother will win the game for her.
Brett had all that cheap jewelry, didn't? Was that the one?
That's the one.
Parents. Now, is that a match?
No, that is not a match.
No.
So far, at this moment, we have a tie. One more mother will break the tie. Mary?
Well, I'll tell you.
What?
We're going to break the tie, mother.
That wins the game. It's your mother up there. There you go. Joe, it was a pleasure to meet you.
In here.
Do vigenia. Thank you very much. Go, Bujanovic. Now, while we're spinning him off, we're going to spin a message or two just for you.
Oh, that's pretty.
Join us next time for Match Game 77. I'm Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.